morning, fellow Toastmasters.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Recall the first day you actually came to Toastmaster, the feeling that you had when you had to talk to people. What was that feeling? Fear. Talking to an unknown audience. How many actually had that feeling? By a show of hands. Not a lot of people.
Fearless.
Very fearless crowd here at the Auburn Toastmaster. But the trivia question for you, what is the term that is used for people who have the fear of public speaking, or even speaking in general?
Public speaking of the
Thank you so much, but that's incorrect.
I once knew it, I forgot.
It's actually glossophobia. Glossophobia is called the fear of public speaking. And unlike the crowd here at Dr. Toastmasters, 74% of people have anxiety of public speaking. They have some degree of glossophobia. There are different extents, from mild, sweaty palms to not able to speak at all. There are different degrees. But we all have it to some extent or the other. We are going to talk about all this complicated pathway in the brain, how the fear is going, how it's happening again, right? No, I'll spare you that horror. That's just for you. You will not go through this. But what I can tell you is it's a very complicated scenario happening inside your head all the time when you are dealing with a fearful situation. Will not go to the exact pathway. Why people have fear of public speaking? What makes them so fearful? Well, my question is, why not? So what is the fun of getting up in front of people with a room full of people staring at you when you can just email them or phone them and communicate whatever you need to communicate, right? For example, if I need to tell Kermit that I'm going to be late for a meeting, why will I tell that to him in person and get that interesting look from him? I don't want that. I'll just email him and call him and say, to avoid that, and say, I'm going to be late, right? Or the audience. You have a room full of audience, some of them are looking at you with horror, some of them are taking a nap. That's no fun, speaking in front. That will, of course, cause you to be more fearful. So, yeah, it's just normal to have the fear of public speaking. Why not? Apart from that, there are a lot of other situations which can cause you more fearful to come up in public and speak. For example, not knowing the topic. Again, that is not very usual for this crowd, as we have witnessed today during the table topics. We have made all kind of stories, even if we don't know if the sea is turtle eats the snail, or what to do when there's lava on our feet, but still we made up. So this, I don't know how far it works for Dogwood, but it's normal. You get fearful when you don't know the topic. Not practicing, that's a lot of us, including myself. So not practicing and not knowing what exactly we are going to talk about can make you fearful. Something situational. If you have to talk in front of a crowd and you know your boss is sitting in the crowd and your promotion depends on it, if you do something wrong, you might get fired, then that can cause fear for you. That is something situational. And the fear of failure, to always think, what if I'm not able to do this well? And with the fear of failure, also what you see is what ifs. We have too many what ifs going on in our head. What if the audience doesn't like this? What if I forget what I'm going to talk about? What if my boss fired me after I say something in the crowd? So all the what ifs in our head constantly going on will cause us to be fearful of public speaking. So where does the fear begin? As you all, I hope you'll agree, it starts just in our own head. As the famous saying goes, that most of the worrying situations we anticipate never actually happen. But we are always thinking in our head that something is going to happen. For example, we are always expecting to be perfect. Our speech has to be perfect. So we should not be doing that. Not expecting ourselves to be, it's okay to be not perfect when you are delivering speech. That way you can control your fear. We equate our public speaking to self-worth. If we are doing a good job speaking in front of people, we think high about ourselves. If we are not able to give our best, then we will think, what am I worth? We have to stop doing that. Because again, it's all going on inside our head. Avoid being nervous about nervousness. It's completely okay to tell ourselves that, why not? We ought to be nervous. We are talking about something which we kind of know about, but not sure if we remember everything. So it's okay to be nervous. And then again in our head, when we write a speech, we are trying to memorize every single word that we have written in that speech. Believe it or not, that can really cause fear. Instead, what we should try doing is remember the key words. That will help you do the speech better. And you will be okay if you are forgetting something here and there. Because what, you know what, the audience does not know what you're going to talk about. It's okay if you forget a few things here and there. And then avoid reading word for word. Because you, when you are just holding a paper and reading word by word, in your head you are thinking, did I prepare myself enough? Again, the same question starts coming up in your head. What will the audience think about me when I'm reading word for word? So that is one way. If you're forgetting, it's okay, but reading word for word is not okay. What are the anxiety symptoms? These are some of the symptoms we can all relate to. Butterflies in stomach, increased heart rate, uncontrollable shakes. This is something I remember when I was doing my icebreaker. I literally asked my evaluator later, did you see my legs shaking? He said, I did not see, but in your head you feel that your legs are absolutely shaking and you may just topple over. Lightheaded and dizziness. Probably it happens to some people, I've never felt right, lightheaded or dizziness. But talk faster or ramble it's very common anxiety symptom. We tend to do a lot. We talk very quickly, no pauses, you just want to get off the stage and run out of the door. That's when you start talking really fast. And then insomnia, which is you're not able to sleep at night. For me it's different because I'm writing a speech the night before, so that's why I don't get sleep. Not more for anxiety. And some of you, it might be more the fear of speaking the next morning, you're not able to sleep at night. So anxiety symptoms are for real. Now, what are some of the strategies that you can use to control the fear of public speaking? First is experience. A lot of members here sitting in this room have been Toastmaster for many, many years, even multiple decades. And that shows when they come up here and they own the stage and they speak. It's the experience. The only way to get better and get more experienced is practice, practice, practice. There is no alternative to that. I repeat, even to myself, there is no alternative to practicing your speech. Second is visualization. When I was doing my research on this topic, this is one strategy I came to know. I cannot speak for everyone, but this is a strategy I use a lot, and I've been doing that since I joined Toastmaster. I'm very bad at writing my speech till the last minute, but to avoid being fearful at the situation, I always imagine myself, even while driving or something, that what I'm going to say when I'm here. So I always keep visualizing that I'm going up on stage, and what are the 3 points or 4 points I'm going to talk about. And then I'm ending the speech, everyone is clapping, and I'm sighing a breath of relief. So when you keep visualizing that over and over in your head, even when you're not actively working on your speech, that can be a great strategy to make you feel comfortable when you're up here and talking. It works great for me. That's how I wrote my first icebreaker speech too, because I kept procrastinating. The only thing I was doing is I was working in the lab, I was doing my experiments, but I was thinking in my head, okay, what can I tell about myself when I go up there? And that's how you can use the technique of visualization to control your fear. Third is isometric training. Exercising can apparently help you really control your fear, You are more relaxed. You are. It will make you less nervous. I mean, I will not suggest you doing isometric training right before you walk up to the stage or during your speech. It won't be very nice if you start squatting or doing push-ups to feel comfortable. But it is something you can practice regularly at home, and it will help you deal with fear. And then breathing exercise. Taking deep breaths in, taking and then in exhaling out, that helps a lot. Just before you come up to speak, when your Toastmaster is introducing, count in your head and breathe 3 deep breaths, and it will help calm you down. That can be another strategy. Now, one technique on the internet that I found is aware technique that is widely used, not just in fear of public speaking, but a lot of other fearful situations also. It's a combination of a lot of things that I was talking about here. That is, accept the anxiety and don't try to fight it. The more you try to fight it and think about, oh my God, I'm getting anxious, oh my God, I'm getting anxious, it will make you more anxious. So let's try not to do that. Then watch the anxiety. As you keep doing practice over and over again, you will realize that when you are being anxious, you are being conscious about it. So when you start watching your anxiety, you can control it better. Act normally. Now, the first one and second one kind of contradicts each other, because one way you are trying to accept anxiety and tell everyone I am anxious. On the other hand, you are trying to act normally as if nothing is going on in your head. But no harm trying. And then repeat the steps. And expect the best. All you can do is just come up here and do the speech, and hoping that it will all go well. So in conclusion, I found this nice definition of fear, which kind of summarizes what we need to do if we want to control our fear of public speaking. That is, face it,